Hello, my name is Dr. Anita Clayton. I'm the Wilford W. Spradlin Professor and Chair of the Department of Psychiatry and Neurobehavioral Sciences and Professor of Clinical Obstetrics and Gynecology at the University of Virginia School of Medicine in Charlottesville, Virginia. The Mountain Study is a randomized double-blind placebo-controlled study of zuranolone 20 milligrams per day, zuranolone 30 milligrams per day, or placebo. They were taken daily in the evening for a 14-day treatment course in patients with major depressive disorder. Change from baseline in the Hamilton Depression Rating Scale, or HAMD-17, total score at day 15 after two doses, and days 5, 8, and 12 were evaluated for rapid onset. The 20 milligrams zuranolone dose did not differ from placebo at any time point, but the 30 milligram per day dose of zuranolone demonstrated a rapid response at day 3, 8, and 12, but not at the end of treatment at day 15. The placebo rate was high, likely affected by multiple visits during the two-week treatment period, and a post-hoc analysis in patients with measurable plasma zuranolone concentrations, or they had severe major depressive disorder with HAMD baseline score of 24 or greater, showed significant improvement over placebo at days 3, 8, 12, and 15. Benefit continued through day 42 and through extended follow-up out 6 months. Treatment emergent adverse effects were similar between zuranolone and placebo groups and included fatigue, somnolence, headache, dizziness, diarrhea, sedation, and nausea. Incidence of weight gain and treatment-emergent sexual dysfunction, as measured by the Changes in Sexual Function Questionnaire, or CSFQ, were low. Loss of consciousness was not observed, and suicidal ideation and behavior assessed using the Validated Columbia Suicide Severity Rating Scale, or CSSRS, decreased from baseline in all treatment groups. So what this study suggested is that the 30 milligram per day dose is the minimum effective dose. So the next study used a dose of 50 milligrams per day of zuranolone. The take-home message from this study is that treatments with new mechanisms of action like a neuroactive steroid GABA-A receptor, positive allosteric modulator like zuranolone, demonstrate rapid antidepressant response to a short 14-day course of treatment at 30 milligrams per day, and there were improvements in functioning and quality of life and lacking chronic adverse effects, and that effect was maintained out to 6 months. However, the primary endpoint at day 15 was not met in this study. So the idea would be to use a higher dose, and we have done subsequent studies using 50 milligrams per day of zuranolone to see if we can see that benefit be positive at day 15. I think if you start to think about the people you might particularly want to use this in, it's not treatment-resistant depression patients. It's people with major depressive disorder. It's also been shown to be effective in postpartum depression. And so that is another group where something like allopregnanolone and acting at the GABA-A receptor has been demonstrated to be quite beneficial. Two studies in postpartum depression were both positive at all time points, really. And then, so you want to use it in major depression or postpartum depression, potentially with people who have greater severity of symptoms, who need or desire a rapid response, who like the idea of time-limited therapy, and the desire to avoid long-term side effects, because that's a problem that really significantly contributes to adherence. But while you have a short course, it still maintains efficacy for long after the drug treatment has ended. If people were severely ill, suicidal, and things like that, I think that that would also be a population we would want to treat rapidly, if possible.